A Greenpoint Williamsburg Public Affairs presentation. This is Neighborhoods Today.
My name is James Glynn, executive producer of Neighborhoods Today. In 1967, I was young, crazy, and lucky enough to have started my own television station, WBCF Channel 19. WBCF was not a broadcast station, but played in the East Village on Channel 1. Channel 1 was a theater where video artists and film artists were able to exhibit their materials. Let me take a few moments to explain how our operation began. In 1966, the Sony Corporation came out with its first home videotape recorder. It was in black and white, and it was half-inch reel-to-reel, much like an audio tape recorder of that day. Along with the Sony video camera, you were able to record a picture as well as audio on tape. I was lucky to be one of four people in New York City to own the equipment. Now that I owned the equipment and the station, it was time to begin thinking about programming. I began with three types of shows: music, talk, and comedy. Next, I needed to put a cast together. They consisted of local neighborhood friends who would gather in this very studio on Friday or Saturday night and with very little or no rehearsal at all would tape a show. The program you're about to see today, Dear Peter, was our talk show. Peter, I would say, was the forerunner of Jerry Springer or Maury. As you can imagine, much of the program was improvised. I would discuss with Pete the topic and the guest for that particular show, and the rest was left to chance. Sometimes it was like one big playpen. A cross-section where we let accidents happen, and they did happen. Sometimes it was like one big outtake. So why don't you sit back, try to relax, as we take a peek back to 1970. Here is Dear Peter.
Welcome to the Dear Peter Show. And today I have the talent scout, Major Bowles, with me. And good evening. Good evening, how are you? And he has some of his talent people. And who was your first person that you wanted?
My first one to perform tonight would be Mr. Archibald Leach. Now, Mr. Leach, I met about 5 years ago. First time I met him was in a mental institution in Calcutta. I brought him back to America, nursed him back to health, and he showed a talent for guitar and harmonica. So I encouraged him deeply to keep moving on this one mainline stream, and now I think he's at the point where he can be shown to the public. He's ready. I hope the public is ready for him.
So in other words, this is the unveiling.
Right. This is his debut.
Let's hear him.
So I want everybody to give him a big welcoming applause.
Let's hear what he sounds like first. Then we'll see if we're going to give you the applause.
What's your selection tonight?
Oh, I'd like to do a song I learned in London called Catch the Wind.
Huh? Catch the Wind. Thank you.
He reminded me of that singer.
Who's that?
Alan Shoeman.
How can you say that? Look, you invited
us. Who do you have next?
You didn't ask to come on this show.
Who do you have next? Do they get better or do they get... Oh, is that your little act?
Yes. My next amateur is Sweetie Nutcracker. Now, Sweetie, in my opinion, has a very interesting background. She was brought up in a small village of Mutton Town in New England. And at the age of 12, she eloped with an archbishop. At 3 years later, she left him to join a combination rodeo and ballet company. 4 years after that, she became, in my opinion, one of America's greatest dancers. Sweetie?
Here she is, folks. Twinkle Toes.
Thank you.
Chief, we had a couple of grapes, we could have some wine.
Sweetie, how can you do this to me?
Maybe you should have left it with the Archbishop. Finally, shoot that music and get that orchestra out of here. That ain't part of your amateur act, too. We have a little extra over there. All right, cut that music back there. Don't make us all ill. Okay, thank you very much. Did it get better or did it get worse? Maybe we should put that voice guy back.
The score is 1-1. It's even so far. Give me a chance.
I think you got the ball from the same in asylum.
Sweetie has been feeling too well lately.
I believe it.
She's 4 months gone. Now, my next amateur is the sensuous woman. Now, that means just how it sounds. This woman is sensuous.
That means a rehabilitation
center. Right. Now, the sensuous woman is going to perform one of her most great and wonderful acts that made her famous throughout England and South America. What is that again, sensuous woman?
White Rabbit.
Okay, we'll have White Rabbit right after this station break.
WBCF Television, Channel 19 in New York.
And we're back. So you wanted to add something to that?
Yes, I once wanted to say a little background on the sensuous woman. I discovered her in a rehabilitation center for...
right next to the mental institution.
For habitual tongue and breath smokers. And she's now going to perform her act, like I said before, that made her famous. And Mr. Leach is going to accompany her in the background.
Oh, you keep it going in all these acts, huh? All right, let's hear her. And we're back.
Well, what'd you think?
So, tell me, do they get worse or do they get better?
Well, I thought you did a splendid job. And
you call her sensuous?
What, you don't think so?
Maybe a different way.
Well, okay. My next, my last and final amateur is Mama Rodriguez.
Last but not least.
Or she's lovingly known as the children by the old lady. Now this woman, this lady, American women can identify with her because she has 15 children and she still finds time to come on television and
That's not an old lady, that's a machine.
you're interrupting. And she's going to, what are you going to sing, Mama?
Ain't no mountain high enough.
What nut house did she come out of?
No, she didn't come out of a nut house. She came out of the Lower East Side tenement. I discovered her scrubbing stoops and singing. And I thought her voice was exceptional, so I signed her up.
Well, we'll see if she should have kept scrubbing the sidewalks or if she's okay.
No, I think she's...
Now we'll hear her.
Very well qualified.
Here she is. The old lady herself.
No way.
So that was Mama Rodriguez, huh?
Right. I think
how good did she sweep the streets?
Very good job, as a matter of fact.
What have you been doing with that yo-yo all the time?
Well, this is my doctor described it as a therapeutic value. It has unlimited therapeutic values. If I don't play with this at least 3 hours a day, I start eating paint off the woodwork. And paint, as you know, has no nutritional value at all. So I must constantly play with the yo-yo, otherwise I go bananas.
You keep bringing people like that around, maybe you better eat the paint. Good night.
Good night.
And good night, Max.
Transportation for the Dear Peter Show was provided by Barbara Zupoli. Production assistants, Marguerite Santoramo, Nick Pinto, and Anne-Marie Boniface. The Dear Peter Show is a Group WBCF television presentation. As you have seen, Peter had quite an assortment of guests to contend with on his show. While the program was taped in black and white, the language sometimes used was very colorful. I hope you've enjoyed our program, and in the future we will be airing more programs from our archives. For Neighborhoods Today Presents, I'm James Glynn. Thank you for watching.